already removed from the table, you gotta answer something in the top lane as well. So EG locking in that first pick with Deer, that doesn't tell you anything about the composition thus far, so Golden Guardians will have to come up with something strong here, answering with the jungle right away and pairing it with a strong combo already makes me fairly excited. This is the strong duo of Talia and Alistar roaming together and picking people off. So it's not quite the point and click from Leona, but you still lock somebody down in place that can get then comboed by Talia.
Yeah, I think we're starting to see this particular jungle trade more and more. Pantheon's banned pretty often. Olaf teams don't often want to play against it, so Udyr's getting through a lot more when he's not banned, and then Talia tends to be the other jungler that people want to go for. So I like the start of the draft for both teams here. I think, as you mentioned, Alistar is a very good pairing alongside Talia, and Kai'Sa has been, I think, the most first picked AD carry, at least in LCS. It seems like teams are gravitating towards her first in a lot of cases, so definitely going to take that one here. See what Igno wants to pair alongside it, but you have plenty of options. Don't think that's the option we're looking for, but you never know. Jazuke sometimes feels like busting out the assassins on occasion.
Threatening that this is a possibility, right?
You know, don't make me do it.
No.
Orianna.
All right. Well, it looks like he has to play one control mage for every non-control mage for Jazuke. So he'll go back to Orianna duty, but it does synergize with the Udyr, with the Kai'Sa. So it's better for the team. So I understand why he's going for this right now. And we'll see if the control mages get to then step up to the plate and match how well he can play these other kinds of champions like the Ryzes or the LeBlancs. Because if he can then play these mages to that level, which is, I think, the hope, since it's been the last year when they also tried this with Jazuke, I think they really want him to be able to take that playstyle or that aggression, that bloodthirstiness, transferred over to the control mages and then evolve EG into a more dynamic team.
Yeah, I mean, we saw like his Ryze probably being a really big point of strength in lock-in as well for EG, so he definitely can do the same thing in a different way, right, where he's just shoving out the wave and then still roaming effectively rather than like roaming effectively and killing people. He's roaming and helping you dive. So I think you know, he's shown success on that champion. I think you can do similar things with Orianna. Interesting that the solo laners for Golden Guardians are going to get later picks here in this draft, but that's pretty typical on red side, I guess, wanting to make sure you get those counter picks. Aziz is going to get banned though. Blizzard may be going to lose Syndra here as well. Those are two of his more comfortable champions and both perfectly good into Orianna, Syndra especially. On the other side, Ignaz losing some playmakers. Rell and Rakan both banned away, which I really like to see. So team's clearly done their homework. They're just trading picks back and forth here, as EG wanting to set up their bottom lane in phase 2 and Golden Guardians need their solo laners in phase 2.
Okay, yeah, and they're banning out the mid lanes because I think Golden Guardians will just take their mid lane now. You have to. You already see the Orianna. No point in saving or in taking Niles' pick right now. And Ablaze will probably pick something really simple. Something... Whoa, what? Why? Why'd you do that?
That's really interesting. So blinding Gnar here and giving giving a Blaze Olive the counter pick instead of the other way around. Impact's like, hey, want to see my jacks?
But you already see the Orianna. Impact's not playing Orianna top. So, I mean, I guess you really wanted the Gnar. It's a possibility that Niles did not feel like he had a pick into the Gnar. So with the Jace being banned, he's thinking, I don't have a champion that matches our composition that can beat Gnar. So let's just take this champion right now. And I don't also think that Impact will have one as well. So he's saying that this champion is just too valuable right now with the bans that have already been delivered for the top lane. And we'll see if it plays out that way. If a Blaze Olive already had his mid lane pick in mind.
All right. Well, Nautilus there for Ignar. Pretty common pairing with the Kai'Sa. We actually saw it just last game. That'd be a cool mix-up if they want to take it. With Il'Genius just to finish off their picks, but Impact, I feel like he hears us when we tell him that he only plays Renekton, by the way, because that's two different champions. Now one we definitely know in the Shen, and Sylas, not something we've seen too often. But that's going to be kind of a fun one there in the top side. And maybe, you know, again, Gnar is like a big champion for Impact, plays a ton in solo queue. Maybe this is like his secret counter pick.
I'm really hypey for this Sylas because you have an Alistar ultimate to steal. You have the Talia wall to steal. You have Xayah. So there's a lot of things that the Sylas can use in a teamfight to just completely throw a wrench in Golden Guardians' plans. They will last pick the Victor for a Blaze Olive. So a lot more damage there, but another crazy ultimate for Impact to steal. I really want to see if he has a great laning phase like he did last time, because he was very exciting to follow throughout the game with the Shen ultimate. And if he has, say, the global of the Talia ultimate, we might get to see a Sylas be all over the map.
Now, the other thing I'm thinking, and maybe one of the reasons Impact even wants his pick in the first place, is that my assumption is that when Sylas steals Gnar ultimate, he just can use it whenever. Because Sylas doesn't get a rage buy. He doesn't transform, right? So he doesn't have the same condition of I need to be Meganar because Sylas is Sylas. He can't be Meganar. I'm assuming that's how that matchup, works. In which
but
case,
it works
like,
with Shyvana, right? Shyvana, he can ult with Shyvana right away.
You don't have to
build anything.
Yeah, I assume that's how it works. Therefore, like that's kind of wild. Like Gnar Ultimate is partly gated by the fact that it's like conditioned on you being transformed. If you don't have to be transformed to use Gnar Ultimate, that is very, very powerful.
Yeah. I hope that's how it works out. That would make the counter pick amazing, and it could actually put an end to all this Gnar nonsense that we've been hearing all split long about whether Gnar is good or not. Great, just pick Sylas and now have a stronger team fighting than him. But we're going to have a level 1 shenanigan already from Evil Geniuses. They have a lot of crowd control between Nautilus, Sylas, and Udyr, and they'll be trying to shadow impact and maybe surprise somebody.
Oh, no.
Niles actually gets caught. He has probably not leveled up yet. We have seen Gnars just hold on to it and level up their hop and get out. And will he do it?
Oh, he gets stunned. That's bad news. I don't know if you can get out at this point. No, you can't. That is first blood for Svenskeren. One flash expended. Just Ignaz.
Oh, man. That really hurts. You get the jungler gold. He can go boots and just completely be so fast on the map. So love to see this out of Impact, though. We usually see these plays from the bot lane, but then Niles is like, oh, it's only Sylas. Guess what? There's really... He would have needed to level up hop over the wall the second you see Niles, and then flash over. That was the only way he could have gotten out of that. Maybe sidestepping, but if Ignar flashes and buffers the auto attack, he's dead anyways, and that's going to be boots for Svenskeren. The jungle gap could be giant here. Movement speed for Udyr is incredible. You don't need any damage items. Everything you need to clear is in your kit, and so he'll just be able to move around faster and clear faster. So we'll have to track Svenskeren versus Iconic this game, because this is the best start for the jungle.
Yeah, that was a really sick level one, actually, but EG, hats off to them for coming up with that plan, punishes Niles. Thankfully, he does the smart thing and doesn't use his flash, so it does at least have that. So no likely revisit, but still a great start here for EG with a nice little plan. Niles is going to try and play pretty aggressive here. Ooh, impact a little too far forward. Nice little step down there for Niles to get out from under the stun. And did actually level hop, so he's going to have to hop onto impact there, but still a ton of damage here in the 1v1. Impact has to know, have to be careful around Minina.
I think he could keep chasing there. You saw that Impact's cooldown on his E was really low, but still had the biscuit. So the biscuit is the thing that really caught Niles off guard. It's like, ah, could we really go for this? If he pops it, am I going to get baited? Doesn't go for it, though. He's very happy to know that his lane is still in the right position. And also is aware that a new deer with boots is on the way.
Ignar, they're already getting in there. Styx eating a lot of damage there as the level 2 was given over to EG here, thanks to their good early management at level 1. Niles also level 2 here, but just going to be trying to push this wave in by the looks of things. Maybe go for a recall, but Impact feeling a lot healthier there. Niles does jump on top, which is a good amount of damage. Continuing to play up and aggressive in this lane, but between all the sustain that Impact has brought to this lane, it's going to be tough for Niles to get anything done without jungler assistance. So I think it'll just be some trading back and forth, and then we'll see what the recalls have in store. As mid lane, Dazuke is out of mana, trying to push in a Blaze Olive. Victor feeling pretty comfy there, though, even on CS right now.
Yeah, he's comfy, but I think we're going to see our first little interaction between junglers here in the top side. Svenskeren in the river, maybe looking for those boots, man. This difference is actually really annoying. Taliyah finished in the top side, and her lanes have pressure. The mid lane of EG has no mana, but because Udyr got boots, he gets there faster, clears the camp, and gets a path bottom and get another thing. It's sad to see for the jungler, but it's a continuation of a smart level 1 for EG, and Svenskeren, jungler that's been MVP, is gonna get advantages from it.
Oh no, it's the jungler disaster crumbs. Two Scuttle Crabs there for Svenskeren, and he'll happily take them again. Those boots, like, unironically helping in that particular instance as well, as he's going to bear stand through his jungle and take those Krugs swiftly flying through the camps at this rate. Now he's continuing to get aggressive here in the 1v1, but Impact very much has things under control. Of note, Impact does have Phase Rush, which to me feels a little bit more like a team fighting skirmishing thing, although it's still looking pretty good now as Niles is getting all in by the Sylas. Impact going back in there and spinning around, and Niles is going to be forced to base here, but Impact did just recently TP in. Niles is still up in CS, so probably going to TP by and then, sorry, recall by and then TP straight back as well.
Yeah, he'll catch that whole wave. There's a cannon there as well to start drawing that turret aggro, so he'll be fine. keeping up NCS and still looking to track these junglers out since Sven Skjern's off to a just a crazy start. 40 CS now to 24. He's the highest farm in the game. He might actually be breaking all the Samsung Fast 5 records here on this game.
That's true.
No one else has gotten this insane start. Like, this is your fastest clearing jungler with the fastest way to be to move around the map early and countering Iconic already taking advantage of his lanes.
Is he dead? Iconic, do not face check the bear. Oh no, it's Sven Skjern. Does just get a little tap and then runs out, so gonna be okay. I guess Sven Skjern has got his speedrun to think about now. His bottom lane hook there lands for Ignite in onto Nubi, but a good punishing pulverize actually as Ignite is ignited. Sixsay could maybe flash in there, but definitely does have the heal at the ready, so doesn't want to commit the summoners, just decides that winning that trade is good enough in bot lane.
Their own heal is still down from the earlier altercation, so they'll just back away and be happy that their junglers are not here. The junglers are all in the top side right now since they just saw Udyr fight the Talia, and he now gets to path back to the bot side. It's interesting because everything that Sven Skjern can get right now, so much of it just revolves around him power clearing, which does leave the lanes by themselves. So everybody's kind of laning just solo without jungle interaction as both Iconic is trying to keep up and Sven Skjern is trying to get away from him by
CS. Oh, Impact is so close to level 6. This is actually very, very important. He's going to hit it, but Niles, how far away is he? Can't be that far, I imagine, as he does indeed ding 6. We'll see about the interaction. Impact maybe going to look to get aggressive, but doesn't land the Q as Niles walks out of it. So I feel like things get very tense all of a sudden in this matchup. Oh, is it? Yeah, that's all done, right? Oh, we missed the Eno! I wanted to know! I think he can use it, but Impact unfortunately didn't land the E.
It looks available, and there's no rage that showed up on him, so I think we're right in that you can just use it right away. And the fact that he went for the all-in before, right after taking the ultimate, but here's a flash!
Ooh, Nubi's in there. Ignite gonna have to flash out, but Sven Skjern's here as well. The counter hook is there, and first blood on the table. Who collects it? It's definitely actually second blood, because apparently I can't count. Now on the bottom side, a Blaze Olive ulting, which is nice, because Stixia was very much in trouble. But Victor needs to try and get something done here, and Sven Skjern's just gonna play bodyguard, so Ignite will live to tell the tale.
Oh no, wasted time for the mid lane, TPing into the bottom lane, using ultimate resources and getting nothing for it while Jizuke is pushing out, gets to harass him, and now Blaze Olive without ultimate. He's going to be fine though, since Jizuke does not have help, but losing out on that teleport is going to hurt since he didn't get anything for it.
Get shockwave. I think he's trying to bait here for Iconic. Oh, Iconic right over the fruit. That actually delays the move speed. Maybe not what he wanted there, but nothing done there, as a Blaze Olive will just walk back to lane with a potion ticking, so I think he should be okay now that Jizuke has been on the ulti. Let's look back down at the bottom side play here.
Ah, so funny out of Jizuke, but yeah, the engage going in right away, but Ignar has flash, and they still have the heal in the bottom lane, so they're able to respond to this, and then with the Victor being down here, flashing in as well, but it's Udyr. He gets a walk out. Maybe that flash and ultimate onto Ignar would have been able to get a kill instead, but hey, we'll never know. And now we're back to the mid lane as Jizuke burns so much to just keep a Blaze Olive here. And it looked silly, but because a Blaze Olive burns so much and doesn't have flash, while Jizuke has his, he can keep himself in this lane and just ensure that a Blaze Olive is constantly shoved into his own turret. So Jizuke's moves, while they do kind of help him out, I think end up helping the jungler even more, since now Sven Skjern will do this, and there's no threat of a mid laner ever collapsing onto this. He can always go, whereas Victor cannot.
Yep, Sven gonna start the Riftchild as a result. Iconic does absorb his jungle item for the Chilling Smite, and is gonna spot this Herald being taken, but as you mentioned, not really much Golden Guardians can do to try and contest. Well, Nubi is actually going to walk back here. He's level 4, though, to the level 5 Ignar. Niles, though, getting in there. Does get the ulti there, but maybe a little bit too early. Niles, though, does get the stunner to Sven Skjern. The seismic shove's going to land as well. Nubi going to finish off the kill. Very well played, but Golden Guardians, can I get anything more here? His Impact going to start spinning around. He doesn't have ulti, though, but indeed definitely does. He's going to go in onto Nubi and get that kill. Niles will be forced to flash, and Rift Herald will go over to EG.
EG had the Kai'Sa much
going again
sooner than the Zayat. Yeah, that's another.
Niles going to get stunned.
What?
Oh, that's death you didn't need to give away. Is definitely on a killing spree, actually, as a Blaze Olive trying to get in there as well. Golden Guardians just going too deep on these plays, and EG will punish them.
Oh, that's like when you go to the store and you buy something and then the cashier tells you, in case you didn't know, it's a 2-for-1. Here's the extra thing that you didn't know you got. Here's some more gold to Evil Geniuses, as definitely is now 4 kills. And you have Niles with the ultimate, and I think that's what got Golden Guardians excited about this, but they have no AD carry here. Even though you kill the Udyr right away, you do have no DPS. You have burst. So when Deathly arrives, they're able to take these fights very easily, and then this re-engage is just silly. I mean, you think you have Xayah in range, but it doesn't matter. You're not going to get anything from this. They steal the Herald, but that is not worth it.
Oh, they did steal it. That's funny. Okay. Well, I mean, that's better than nothing. I didn't realize that a Blaze Orb actually was able to steal it. Gonna get the blue buff now as well, and as you can see, yes, does indeed have the Eye of the Herald over his trinket slot. You know what? If they get a Terra out of it, maybe it'll be worth it. Still got some plate time as well, so I guess not as bad as maybe looks on first appearance. Good combo there for Newbie, but definitely able to flash out.
That is really quick fingers out of Deathly. I mean, the combo was so fast, he was not brought back from the seismic shove, and now that's a big commitment on the side of Golden Guardians. You showed your hand that you were waiting in that brush, and by waiting there, you give up control of the river. So now EG just gets to walk in and get a free dragon out of that one. So it's already two moves from Golden Guardians that haven't really turned into anything. They'll have to go back onto Deathly, though. He's the one member that doesn't have flash, and prioritizing the bot lane will be the way to get this game back on track. You need the Alistar to be a constant threat so that he's comfortable enough to go for flanks when team fights break out.
Yeah, I think especially because the other side of the coin, Deathly has been the big winner of these early engagements. He's 4-0-1 on the Kai'Sa right now. A little bit behind in farm, but obviously going to be ahead in gold up against Tixase, so feeling comfy, should have that mythic item done in no time at all. And should be smooth sailing there into the mid game for Evil Geniuses as they're up 2,500 gold. Pretty nice, all things considered. And as you can see, definitely indeed top of the mountain there for gold. Blaze Olive does have his first upgrade. As a reminder, Victor got changed a while ago, actually. But he doesn't have his little item anymore. He just gets, I think, Hextech Shrapnel, it's called. He like, collects bits and then cashes them in for upgrades now. So same mechanic, just no item.
Kind of like GP, but the item was a cool thing to see. Okay, let's see if something happens in the top side. Since Svenskeren did get spotted out by that crab.
Ooh, counter ulti. Actually, Impact getting stunned up here. He does get the stun on the end of it all, but Iconic maybe can do enough damage. Now it's a little bit too low, though, and Svenskeren's able to finish it off mid lane. Blaze Olive getting aggressive onto Jazuke, which you like to see. Now going to try and cordon him off here, but Jazuke ready with the counter shockwave. Blaze Olive going forward, trying to dodge the potential ball damage. But Shockwave, just barely going to get him. And Jazuke, what a solo kill. Just barely picks off the mid laner.
Ooh, got to see an emote on that corpse. If not going to get it. But that fight in the top side, I mean, the Jazuke all in is one thing. The fight in the 2v2, you saw the Udyr was there, right? They had full information of who was going to be in that play. They still went forward thinking that they could burst down the Sylas. And it's an unfamiliarity with the matchup. You don't know how much he's going to be healing. And so they think they can burst him down. He has just enough health to survive the combo and get his ultimate off.
Yeah, unfortunately for Iconic, you know, his delay has been very good since the start of the season, and it seems like he's got at least some tools in these lanes to try and set things up with, and just hasn't really been able to find the same early game success he was having in his opening games back in Lockean, as the Rift Herald was indeed dropped by a Blaze Olive. Did have to use it there, and I think it's going to be cut off at the pass here pretty aggressively by Dezuke. He's already getting the lane pushed in.
So you bring up Taliyah, and one thing I noticed out of Blabber in his game on Taliyah is that he rushed the Sorcerer shoes. So prioritizing mobility seems to be a much better option for a lot of junglers now, just because they're clear so fast and that the new jungle items allow you to stay much more healthy in mana and HP in the jungle. So mobility is the way to speed your clear. So here we go. They're thinking of taking him down. It looks so close. Almost gets out too, but Sylas's W just gives him way too much sustain to live through it all.
Yeah, ran out of damage. Did not have the burst, unfortunately, to finish off that kill. So, did go the way of Evil Geniuses, much like most of this game has been going, unfortunately, for the Golden Guardian side. Threat of a dive now. 4v2 here for Golden Guardians. Gonna have to give up this tower. 16 newbie can't really do anything, so at least they back off to not get killed, but doesn't feel good to be giving up plates and a full tower here over to EG. Right on time as well. Just gonna miss the last one, but not a big deal there for Evil Geniuses. Definitely still extremely rich in this game.
You would have loved to see a teleport out of that bot lane, because Niles has a ward to defend that tier 1 bot lane, and with the Alistar and Xayah there, if Iconic was in range to use an ultimate, you could have surprised evil geniuses and try to get a kill there, since Deathly doesn't have flash and is the highest gold member with a bounty on him. So Golden Guardians will pass up on that opportunity, not wanting to perhaps get countered by Impact and Jazuka, who now has TP, but that's an option that I saw. They didn't go for it, but they'll have to look for those plays again. Teleporting Niles into the back of the enemy team is a great way to play Gnar and also get some kills while the laning phase is still going on.
Well, Impact's back at it again. Niles are about to transform. Oh, gets him into the tower. Wallops as well. Going to take a couple shots here. But the Bolotots is going to miss, and he's getting dove now. 4v1 in the top lane. Now he needs the teleport help.
Thumbs up.
Yeah, wave is there. Impact's got the ulti, and I think Niles is just going to be left dead to rights. Indeed he will, as Impact picks up the kill.
Why do they peek on Niles so much? Every game, they're always picking on Niles. Whether he's playing Gangplank, Camille, or Gnar, they find ways to just kill the top lane, and Golden Guardians is not there to help him out. I mean, I'm answering the question there. It's because the rest of the team isn't there to help him out, so they can sniff that out and immediately go for it. And whereas Golden Guardians here, when they're pushing this turret, well, there's nobody here. So EG knows that the counterplay would be the cross-map bot lane. Nobody should defend this, or else they would die, and they're happy to do so, just to give it up, because they got a turret, tempo, and a kill.
Might lose more on the extension here, though. Jeffly does have ulti. Jazuke also threatening a Blaze Olive, who actually can't stand here. It's, again, 4v1 under a tower. As a Blaze Olive, he's going to have to give up his mid outer tower. So EG fell the outer ring. They're still up 5,000 gold or so with most of their mythics completed. So things looking good. Got their first dragon as well. Can maybe even fall back to take the second here. So they have the Dragon Soul Snowball as a win condition as well. And that does seem to be the play here, as Iconic going back to base will not be contesting for this Drake.
Yeah, it's looking phenomenal on the side of EG. And on Golden Guardians, if they want to start clawing back into this game, they need to start moving this vision again, because the control wars that they currently have are almost too far out. Now that they've already lost tier ones, they need to bring those control wars a little further back so that they can see what EG is doing, because EG is going to be playing a little more extended, and so the vision isn't going to actually catch anybody else. So Golden Guardians needs to buy control wars and start defending where they think Evil Geniuses will strike next. And it looks like they're going to be doing so around the mid lane, as that's the area where they have now placed four wards, and it also helps Stixxay out, who has been a pretty good carry for them.
All right, so now we've got a bit of time. We did confirm, thank you, StatsBot, for letting us know that the Sylas interaction with Gnar Ultimate does work the way we think it does. Hold that thought, though. Golden Guardians looking to spring the trap onto Ignar. Seismic Shove going to be sidestepped, and unfortunately for GG, had four people in a good spot, but do not get a kill.
Call an ambulance, but not for me. That's exactly what Ignar was doing there. Instantly ult and gets the flash. He didn't even have to flash. He didn't even hook out of that. There was no fear in him. He's like, you're walking at me with a Kai'Sa behind me with four kills. We're 8-1 up, please. Very confident out of him, and I love to see that from players where they know their limits and just calling it out. It's like, what? You're trying to fight here? We can turn on this. The Kai'Sa is strong enough.
It's a shame we didn't get to see the Sylas Orianna interaction. It's kind of the inverse of the Gnar interaction. Good shockwave speaking off by Jazuke, but Niles should be able to live. Since Garen may be threatening a dive, though, Megan are about to happen, so it does get a boost of extra health and just boulder tosses almost all of the wave out, but is going to have to go back to base. Of course, oh, actually, we'll talk about it later. There's the Stolen Victor ulti this time. Going to drop it there onto a Blaze Olive and definitely here to finish it off. Oh my goodness, that was disgusting. Wow. Collected by definitely in these two items.
Jeez, the Akathian range collector combo is pretty nuts, right? You're not missing anything, you're just deleting enemies off the rip. A Blaze Olive had no way to flash out of that one and live, so it's EG just finding more opportunities. And it was that vision that Golden Guardians had laid down on their side of the map. It didn't matter. Deathly was able to go through it with the quickness of the Mountain Drake now on the blue side and just start to surprise this AD carry, all while Jazuke is farming up a storm. I'm loving what I'm seeing out of him. He's playing Orianna right now, similar to the way he likes to play his LeBlancs, his Echoes, his Ryzes, just being super aggressive and using abilities constantly just to gain pressure. Then, when he has that advantage, he can then freely take camps, freely rotate between lanes, knowing that he's not going to be in danger. So it's an Orianna that's just prioritizing getting strong and denying the opportunity to play make against her.
All right, Niles in a 1v2, soon to be a 1v3. Going to try and have to jump onto the Jizuke. Does get damage down. Decent little shove, but Iconic's here, and I don't think he can save his top lane. Absolutely just going to book it out of there as Niles will fall to Svenskeren.
Thumbs up again. Nothing to it but smile through the pain for Niles. Just so much camp. Five deaths already. I mean, there's nothing else going on the map. Victor's pushing. There's no setup for a defense, so who else is going to be doing something on the map? He's trying to get some gold. He's trying to push out and get something here because Golden Guardians is not combining their only utility that can actually engage on what EG has thus far. It's Alistar and Iconic that have to find a play. Last we saw, it was an attempt on Deathly, but he just flashed out.
Yeah, decent chunk on Svenskeren, but no follow-up, unfortunately, there for Golden Guardians. Do kill the Rift Herald, but it took out the top tier 2, as Deathly is doing the same here in the mid lane. Golden Guardians really just have no room at all in this game. Just the one tower in bottom lane is the only one they have killed so far in this game. Jizuke is going to answer the tier 2 push here in bot. And all this room to move through the top side, especially for Evil Geniuses, mean they can just cut off all this vision, get aggressive in the jungle just like this. As Impact's going to steal the Alistar ulti, always a good one to have on hand. In fact, he's just in there. 1v4, going to pop the Alistar ulti, maybe a little too far as Impact will flash out. Niles looking to cut him off. Ignar perhaps the better target, but not going to get slowed there by the boomerang. And Ignar hooks off to the tower rubble to safety.
If you have Alistar ultimate, then you are excused to limit test here because
there are no limits. Else?
Well, right, exactly. You're limitless now. You pop the pill, suddenly you can see all the numbers. You know all the lottery tickets, winners, and everything else. So the Alistar ultimate is amazing for Impact, and I think he'll be looking for that one when way more fights. Him and Udyr diving in the backline like that is just so deadly, since now Orianna can support them, and she's just been farming up a quiet storm there. In fact, the carries as well here. It's only Stixxay that has now broken into the 200 digits for Golden Guardians, and I think he is really who Golden Guardians have been playing around in the first few games around Lockin. He seemed to be a pretty competent carry in these late games, and so if they want to have some miracle here, Stixxay is the one to do it.
Yeah, I mean, this Tempo Zaya pretty good as the game goes on, but third dragon's going to mean a pretty quick Cloud Soul here for EG in after 5 minutes, if they do, of course, get the Drake, which leads me to the question I was alluding to earlier, Crumbs. Can Udyr activate the ultimate Cloud Soul move speed?
No.
No?
No.
That's very disappointing.
Right? He doesn't get it.
I mean, my assumption is that Phoenix is coded as one, but that seems kind of insane. although I think it, from memory, Cloud Soul has a cooldown. Anyway, another question we can answer later on in the week, perhaps, as Ignar is zooming up top, gets the ulti in onto Nubi, who does not have his ultimate. Oh, no! Hooked Iconic instead as Nubi sets it up for the enemy team. Deathly's charging in. He's got Gale Force. He's probably got 3 items at this point. He's dominating as he takes down the ultless Alistar.
All right, you know the game is over when the engage is ulting the Alistar, right? You usually are ulting the carry or somebody else, but the Alistar at max range Nautilus ultimate is the opportunity you're looking for, and now Stixxay's dead.
Oh, Impact. The old Gnar ult that he's picked up is going to take out Stixxay. Oh. Niles and Abloy himself do combo together to kill Jizuke. That is a good shutdown, but can they get any more? I don't think they can, as also Baron is being taken by Kai'Sa and Udyr.
That's funny. That's 2 carries getting killed by Gnar ultimate.
So unfortunate.
So we'll see. Look at that. Oh, a newbie baiting your jungler, flashing away from the hook. Gets the Taliyah killed. Should have taken the L right there and not gotten more members killed. But how could you know? How could you know that it wasn't going to
hit
the wall?
I love this. Carry? Just sits in the brush with the stolen Gnar ulti and just all-ins poor Stixxay.
And then Jizuke. Oh, the same thing. The same thing happens to 2 people. Oh, man. It's like the horror movie. One person goes in and is like, oh, should I go follow? Somehow, they always do. Yet the audience just is screaming, please do not check that brush.
All right. Well, it was checked, and the expected result did happen as a result. Also, by the way, Red Bull Baron buff over to EG, which we did expect them to get in the replay, and indeed they did pick it up. There were no shenanigans that ensued from that point. So Evil Genius is up 10, almost 10,000 gold, about 9,500 or so. So looking in a pretty good spot to close out this game. We'll see if GG have a team fight in them here. Can see the setup, but it is going to be a struggle with how far down they are. EVG really can just play the map in almost any configuration they want here right now. They're going to move up mid and bottom lane, TP down bot side for Jazuki as they're going to overload this mid and bot section, but Golden Guardian's getting some chip damage down onto Ignar as the Baron minions stream in.
I want to see some Talia walls, some combos into something. We've yet to see anything, and now they're getting dope.
And Svensgarin just runs in and takes out a Blaze Orb. Three-man pull for newbie, not bad. Impact, though, has got the Arthur ulti, so you know what that means. There's no limits. Crumbs' impact. He's straight in there as Niles is going to be forced to flash away. Goodness, the damage. He is massive from the two mages as Jazuki. Maybe a little bit too far forward. It's not even close. Impact. That's very nice looking, but he is going to die at the end of the day. Stixxay able to pick him up, but definitely popping off as he moves forward there. Gale forces into Stixxay going legendary and picking off everybody else almost as Iconic is alive. The ace is not there, but the game certainly will be there. As evil geniuses are going to take down Golden Guardians in style.
There's the wall.
Okay, okay. Surely. 25 seconds on 6A, 5 on Victor. They actually are going to back off.
It worked. Yes, the wall stopped the end, but it's already over. 12,000 gold lead. They could not really defend this. They were trying to dive, and definitely was just aching to proc that collector. And here we see the shockwave onto a Blaze Olive, right? The QW removes the Banshee's Veil, which was just purchased to deal with Nautilus and maybe Udyr, but it's so easy for the rest of the members to burn through that. And then it's all about the dive, the limitless impact there. How many turret shots is he tanking there? Still taking another, still going in. He's got the Zhonya's there. Hey, if Orihanna was closer there, we might have even been able to see Jazuke shield him in time and keep him alive longer for another W.
Definitely is really having a breakout game, by the way. I mean, he's looked pretty good, but this is a game where certainly he has been set up for success, and he is bringing that here for Evil Geniuses. 8-0-3 on this Kai'Sa. Three items well and truly done. Fourth one is zooming up as he's collected so much gold this game.
Yeah, because I got Deftly on my fantasy, also Niles. So, right, yes. The right, 8 kills and 6 deaths. So I think it works in my favor to have more kills here for the fantasy.
Well, as we've heard from Azale, AD carries pretty good pickups here in fantasy. And certainly Deftly is proving his fantasy point worth, among other things, in this game. EG going to take that Cloud Soul. And we did learn, thank you, Robostats, chiming in once again. Udyr apparently procs it on all his stances, but the buff, as I expected, does have an internal cooldown, so he's gonna be real fast, as you
can
see.
So so he's basically always triggering it just on every stance.
Yes, but it doesn't trigger like 24/7, you know.
Yeah,
it does have an
internal
cooldown.
Yeah. Okay.
That's pretty cool. I mean, you know, it makes sense. Buff makes you go faster. Udyr goes faster. Yeah, I mean, look at him go. Udyr is such a great champion. Genuinely, I love that he's in the league right now as Golden Guardian trying to defend this top half.
Look at him go.
He's got the supers in the bottom side still streaming through.
Oh, can we just follow him running around?
I'd be down for like over-the-shoulder Udyr cam. Oh, Ignar, though. Gonna maybe look to end the game here, locking up newbie in the front side. Oh, impact! What a play! Stole the RLT that makes it sing. Has definitely gonna move in there as well. The shockwave is good from Jazuki as he finds two. A double kill there for definitely. The Penta could be incoming there. Give it to him. Stole one as Jazuki does get a kill for himself, but definitely still moving in. A Blaze Orb here gonna get stunned up by Svensgarin, who's gonna get the kill that will in fact be Udyr. One more for the ace. The Nexus is open, and Evil Geniuses this time, Crumbs, this time they will get the ace. Oh no, they'll get Jazuki killed instead, but they will take the Nexus. Definitely going to shoot it down. Iconic going to defend what he can, but definitely going to make sure that doesn't happen. What a play for the Bloodline Aces. Definitely is going to make Evil Geniuses pick up yet another win as they take out the GG Nexus. That was a fun one.
Dang, Deftly is getting really stylish in this league. For so long, we're like, oh, how good is Deftly? Can he really make it into the LCS? Well, yeah. He is really good right now on this EG roster. Suddenly, we don't really know where to rank him. We just know he continues to get kills, he works well with the squad, and he doesn't die. So that same avoidance of death and kind of ensuring that you're always strong with your farm, with your team fighting, is always his MO. That's definitely kind of the idea behind the name, and now he's actually playing like it.
Yeah, I mean, he heard you, Crumbs. He wanted to make sure you get a few more fantasy points there. I think, 11-0-6 at the end of that game, if my memory serves. But picking up all the kills to have had the stats at the end of that one. Very impressive stuff from Deftly and squad. Really just kind of a total domination there for EG, which I think was maybe somewhat expected. You could see what Golden Guardians were trying to fight. But something is missing in cohesion for this team. And I do believe they will get there. Absolutely. It's still early. I think expectations do need to be managed properly for Golden Guardians, and you can't take away the bright spots they have shown early on in the season. But EG, unless they stumble, they feel like a very well-organized, very well-coordinated team, and they do take a very clean-looking victory here. We're going to be going off to a break, but